about you? No, God blessed him. God blessed him. God took care of him. He prospered. He moved out. Hallelujah. Think about it. Think about the job you got right now. Think about, my God. Think about that 10 Lizzie you drive. You drive something. Come on, get down on your. Think about how God done bless you. Look at going in your closet. Look at the clothes you got. Some of the stuff, my God, y'all won't throw it away. You know you ain't gonna never wear it. You ain't gonna get back in. God kept it in the Bible. But Jacob, you gotta go back. You gotta go back to Bethel. Don't y'all agree with me? That Jacob had to go back to Bethel. Oh my God, he had to return. He had to go back and renew his vow. He had to go back and get connected again. He had to go back for a brand new start. Anybody need a new start this morning? Anybody need to go back to Bethel? You see, Jacob was so busy. He was so busy with his business.
Don't you say?
He was so busy taking care of his children. He was so busy working to get rich. Getting sheep and cattle. Hallelujah. And he forgot all about Bethel. He forgot all about the house of God. Well, I'll go when I get time. You see, things kept him from church service. And I gotta make this money. Things kept him from the prayer meeting. Well, I pray for a while, I ain't got time. Things kept him from the Bible study. Well, I'm just a woman, I guess how bad I can. Now, if you had Bible for those words out here. He forgot about the house of God. Jacob had gone too long without the experience of Bethel. Do you know any Jacobs? Look at your neighbor and say, do you know any Jacobs? You're not careful. The elder woman say, look in the mirror. Because you're not careful. We too can drift away from that. You too can drift away from your obligation. Drift away from your ministry. Drift away from your church. Your God's house, God's church, the service become something or sometime thing or once in a while. I don't feel like it. I'm tired. I worked all day. Are y'all on me? Hallelujah. I ain't throwing off at nobody. I'm just telling the truth. Just once in a while. Hallelujah. But you need a fresh touch. Even working in the church, that don't exclude you that in the church here every time the door's open and see. In the church, every service, ushering on the usher board, singing in the choir. Hallelujah. Being the head of an auxiliary, doing the duty of a deacon. I'm here, I'm faithful about that. But see, it's more than just coming to church. You come to church, that's all right. But when you get here, you got to take the time. You got to put forth the effort to get in the presence of God. Let's go be in church. That woman with the issue of blood, Father, she could have got with the crowd and watched as Jesus passed by. Hallelujah. He said, no, woman, if I really want it from you, I ain't just got to let this crowd stop me. If I got to crawl, whatever it takes, then I got to touch the human of God. And somebody had to touch the Lord this morning. No, we didn't have God. Some of y'all still in the same state. You still in the same mind. You still. Some of y'all sitting there fighting sleep. Some of y'all ain't hearing nothing I said. Hallelujah. But you gotta put a demand on the spirit. You just can't come and sit here. You gotta say, Lord, why don't others die or call? Don't pass me by. If you're blessing that person behind you, how come you ain't blessed? Look at that over there jumping. How come? Hallelujah. In other words, don't just come to church, but come and get something from the Lord. Take time to enjoy the Lord. We gotta love the Lord. Is that right? Is that right? You gotta enjoy the Lord. You gotta see God in everything. See Him in the choir. See Him in the preaching. Is that right? Is that right? Let Him refresh you. Let Him revive your spirit. And some of us need to be revived. Oh man, you've been in the church so long until you'll probably never leave the church, but what good is it if the church ain't doing nothing for you? You can write the word, you know the word, you can quote scripture, but what good is it if you don't apply it? How many know it'll work if you work it? And if you don't do this, if you don't put a demand on the Spirit, if you don't come with expectancy, God, I'm looking for your visitation, for a manifestation of your glory. If you don't come with that attitude, you too can move into a backslidden state of mind in the church. But don't have no deliverance. In the church, we don't have no joy. In the church, hallelujah, don't have no prayer. Working in our glad to see it. Never feel the power of God. Never feel his joy, his anointing. It's in the rain. Y'all remember the story of the prodigal son? Yeah, that prodigal son, he left home, but guess what? He ain't came to himself. Before it got too late, he came to himself and he went back to his father. But the one that was lost was the son that was at home. The one that was at home was sitting home, mad and upset. Wanted daddy to cut the son off. Y'all don't hear me. So you can be in the house and still be lost. Jacob needed to go back to Bethel. He needed time for worship. He needed time to lead his family to God. He's the priest and the prophet of this house. He gotta let his children know that ain't but one source, and that's God. He needed time for holy things. Spent all his time with sheep and goats and cattle and camel and trying to get rich. He had wrapped himself up day and night for over 20 years. Do y'all follow me? New G, new generation. New G, after 21 days of fasting. Do y'all hear me? Yeah. Hallelujah. God is calling us to go back to our Bethels. If you don't, 2012 will be just like 2011. Hallelujah. Yeah, you're going to have a repeat performance. You're going to go over and over. You're going to go around and around the same mountain. You're going to go around and around the world. Never enter into the promise. Hallelujah. Do you hear me? But we got to get ready this morning. We got to get ready to go back to our Bethel. We got to get ready to go back to the place where we were anointed. We got to get back to the place where we were called. We got to get back to the place where we received the Holy Ghost. Get back to that place of surrender. Y'all know that? That place where God made you brand new. We got to get back to that. Anybody want to go back this morning? Like Jacob, we got to get back. Hallelujah. And the vision that was given to Jacob, he got a vision of a ladder. A ladder that descended from earth to glory. And there were angels ascending and descending on this ladder. Hallelujah. And I tell you, Church of God, that it's from faith to faith. It's from glory to glory. It's from one experience to another experience. In other words, we're climbing Jacob's ladder. I ain't talking about no matter what. Glory to God. But every time you go up, yes, you've got some circumstances. But guess what God says? Every level I take you, you've got trials and tribulations. Every level I take you, you've got some vicissitudes and you got some adversity to get you. But guess what? In every level that you go, there's an angel to see you through. Is that right? I've got my angels. In fact, I got one angel named Goodness. And there's another angel named Mercy. Look at somebody say, Goodness and Mercy shall follow me all the days. Part of my day. You got some help. You ain't by yourself, Regina. You got some help. You ain't by yourself, Angel. Terry, you ain't by yourself. some help. With God, not to lose Michael.